The race for the Rocket has just a few days remaining, and Sidney Crosby is the front runner, one up on Ovechkin and Stamkos entering play on Friday. Kevin Weeks joined me earlier to discuss what makes these three so lethal. Kev, let's start with Steven Stamkos and how he has found a way to become such a dominant sniper in the NHL. Let's dissect some of his goal-scoring prowess, and from your vantage point, I'm keenly interested here in how you evaluate his performance.
Well, he lurks in the weeds is what he does, and you'll take a look at this power play right here. Stop it right here. Take a look at Stamkos. Look at his ability to uncheck himself. There's absolutely nobody around him. Everybody else, there's double coverage on Steve Downey, who wears number 9 for Tampa. Almost triple coverage, if you will. And that leaves Stamkos completely open. Bang! Good night. There's one. You'll see the same look right here. And he just has that uncanny ability to uncheck himself from the defenders. And people will argue, well, it's a power play situation. But he still does the same thing on 5-on-5 situations as well. This is a misread here by Blake Como, and Stamkos is able to take advantage. He's a one-shot guy. All it takes is one shot for him to beat you, and he has similar traits to both Ovechkin and Sid Crosby that way. But he isn't a one-trick pony. Look at him here on the other side. Different setup here, different look on his strong side, being a right-hand shot. And watch this play. You can't even see him there. He's going to the net, beats Ferentz back door, just sneaks in there quietly, and he just has that ability to do that. So from playing against him, you know what he's going to do on the power play. You know what he wants to do on the power play, but you don't defend him. And most teams haven't found a way to defend against him. There's usually a lapse on the backside forward and D. There's a miscommunication, and he's able to exploit that and put it home all the time. But he is more than a one-trick pony, I tell
True
you.
Or false, you knew what he was about to do this year, and that's why you're here with us.
False.
Oh,
false. I beat those guys twice last year.
There
false.
You go. See, you pushed him further along in his career. Now, how about Sidney Crosby? I mean, again, you saw him up close. You know what Sid is all about, but this year has been a different Crosby. So why is he scoring more now?
Well, why Sidney Crosby scoring more is because it's more of a pick your poison. How do you want it? How do you want him to serve it up? Take a look at the diligence. Here he is putting on his hard hat, construction helmet, and going to the net. Got the work boots on, out. Hustles two Leaf defenders, Boschman and Luke Shen there. And here he is here, waiting at the blue line. Just waiting. You can't see him. There he is. Great anticipation. Oh, sorry. Comes in, deposits this one through Jose's five hole. But again, he can beat you in so many different ways. This year, he's become more of a shooter. He's become stronger and more of a complete player. And he's willing to shoot the puck more. Now, this is just a thing of beauty, folks. Take a look at him in the open ice. That's where people get mesmerized. And usually in that situation, he's going to do a nice behind-the-back pass or a saucer pass. Not this year. Goes high over Kerry Lehtinen. Here's another one. Unchecks himself, much like Stamkos there. Finds the gray ice, quiet ice. The Rangers don't even recognize that he's there before you can look around. Red light special in the back of the net.
It's interesting, you know, because Crosby and Ovechkin are in the race for the Rocket. Pittsburgh fans are very sensitive to the fact that Ovi has done well against Pittsburgh, and they were really upset with Dan Bylsma for leaving the net open the other night and allowing Ovi to push forward in the race for the Rocket. So we know Ovi gets his empty netters, but he finds a way to beat the netminders too. How?
How not? He scores in so many different ways, folks. This guy is so dynamic. The puck absolutely jumps off his stick without question. Take a look at this. Oh, speed. Just whoosh this one far side. Waltzes Stefan Robitaille, who's an excellent defenseman for the Stars. And this one here, you'll find him just lurk. Just wait. Just wait. There it is. The wrist shot beats Toskala. Great look by Backstrom drawing the defenders. And the thing about Ovechkin, again, he too is a one-shot guy. He's not a guy that needs 10-plus shots to score a goal. He can beat you anytime, particularly off the rush. Here's one where he just sneaks in there. High. So how many guys are able to beat a goalie
one.
With a wrist shot?
Him.
Him, the only one from there, from that distance. And that was 3-4 feet inside the blue line. Watch this one here. Okay, forget the wrist, or I'm going to go slapper. Shelf, penthouse, glove side on Pavlik, who has an unbelievable glove hand, by the way. And he's just hungry, and he's so strong. He's like a running back on ice. You see him here in the open ice. Before Marc-Andre Fleury can even get down in a butterfly, he deposits this 1-5 hole. So imagine him being 6'2", 235 pounds. He has the build of an NFL running back, and the speed, desire, and hunger, and the will to score every time he's on the ice, every shift. So all different, They get it done in different ways, but each one of them is equally lethal.
Yes, and great breakdown. Dan Rosen did likewise on NHL.com. We encourage you to read this terrific article about the game's greatest snipers. It's all access all the time. Visit NHL.com.